Good morning, Thursday morning, ending the week with an incredible lineup of meetings today. Starting at WeWork headquarters this morning, meeting an entrepreneur that has had several success stories and is building somewhat of a very, very interesting venture. Also, the person that introduced me is very interesting, so it's going to be a fascinating meeting. And then I'm meeting a US VC that's in Israel that actually reached out to someone and asked to introduce them to me. She called me a manbassador, as in somebody who promotes female entrepreneurs on my vlog. So I love that. Gonna meet her and talk to her about Israeli tech, and then giving a talk at WeWork headquarters about marketing. So it's going to be a phenomenal day. A couple other meetings, and then the weekend. It's all good. Here we go. Tel Aviv to WeWork headquarters here at Hazerem. Check it out. This is WeWork headquarters, by far the coolest building. Look at this place. Check this out. Okay, so I've said this before and I'll say it again. The reason I started this vlog is because I found that there are fascinating people in this country, and while everyone's talking about Israeli tech around the world, no one knows the people. I think today illustrates that point more than anything. So how did we originally connect? Who introduced us?
A friend of mine, I live in the north of the country, so right. A friend of mine named Iran hooked us up, sent an email, introduced us, and
okay, so Iran,
I've been looking at your blog.
Thank you. We'll talk about that in a second. But Iran works at a company called Lightrix,
which
is a phenomenal company. If you go to the App Store at any given moment, they're at the top of the paid apps, and they're sitting in Jerusalem. It's a phenomenal company. Make Facetune and Enlight and all kinds of other apps. Amazing. He reached out to me and said, listen, you need to meet this guy. Super fascinating dude. He that was like the biggest understatement of the century. That's all I have to say about that. What's your name?
Hey, Eitan Chamberlain.
Eitan Chamberlain. First of all, right there, in and of itself, it's just fascinating right there. You don't hear a name like that ever.
No.
You know Jackie Mason, the comedian?
Yeah.
You know, you ever hear what he says about names?
No.
He goes, all the Jews, they want to sound like they're more Gentiles. And you know who sounds more Jewish? All the Gentiles. Whoopi Goldberg.
That's right.
So Eitan Chamberlain.
And no one did more for the state of Israel than Chamberlain, right?
100%. So let's just real quick run through your background. Where were you born?
I was born in Atlanta, Georgia.
Atlanta, Georgia. Then you moved to?
Florida.
Florida. Then you moved to?
Then up to Langley, British Columbia, Canada.
Okay, you were a devout Christian.
Yes, grew up, yes.
And you were fascinated by, let's call it archaeology, about, you know, the history and the Bible and language and all these things, right? Is that a fair statement?
Yeah, I went on to study 12 ancient languages.
Okay, phenomenal. And then you made a decision in your life, you converted to Judaism.
That's right.
Why?
I had a passion for the Torah. I had a passion for raising my kids ethically, probably from the Christian faith, probably from growing up in that world.
Absolutely love it. Okay.
You know?
So that's on the personal front. Then you moved to Israel when?
I moved to Israel in 2004.
Let me just straighten this out a little bit. Give me a minute. 2004, you moved to Israel. Why?
Why? A passion for the land. A passion for the land. I'd already been a student here for several years, doing a master's degree in archaeology, and had excavated around the country, had friends, and had lived the life cycle, and just felt this is a land of opportunity.
I freaking love it, man. I love that you just called Israel the land of opportunity. It's amazing, especially a guy from the USA, the land of opportunity, Israel. I'm looking on it. I love it. Okay, let's just jump right ahead. You have a company. You have what is perhaps the coolest domain name, or the coolest domain that's ever been on this vlog. What is the domain of your company?
Stops.com.
Stops.com. Like, drum roll, please. That is unbelievable. That is the most unbelievable. Like, it's just unbelievable. Okay, what is Stops.com?
Stops is a aggregator and a creator of content for augmented reality. So every time we stop, we can create or inject things in a geo position, and our friends, even just ourselves, but we can scale it up to our friends, we can scale it up to the rest of the world, but it first starts with ourselves. We can leave memories behind at geo positions, and then people can follow in those memories from stop to stop anywhere in the world.
Okay, let me dumb this down a little bit, because you know, you're obviously extremely passionate, which you need to be, but I think if someone's watching this, they might have missed the foundation here. What's the foundation? The foundation is you yourself are very involved in the travel industry. You're a tour guide in many, and you would stop along the way, right? You're giving a tour, you'd stop, and you'd talk about that rock. The person who's watching stopped with you is looking at that hammock over there, and you, different context, what I see is not what you see, etc. And you said context is extremely important. I always talk about this, you know, I talk about context with intro. Someone makes an intro, make sure that each side has the right context. Context is everything. But we talk about context in other contexts, but when it comes to the world, the physical world, Earth, there's no context. I want the context of that tree over there. What happened in that location 3,000 years ago? I don't know, because there's no context. And another thing to add to that is one of the, you know, one of the sources of information in our lives, in our digital lives, is Wikipedia and just in general, Google and, you know, search and the internet. And we, I don't need to tell anyone how big of a problem fake news is in you know, being and just inaccurate information. It's just not, there's no accurate, authoritative source of context for the things around us. You're building that.
That's right. We're building that. We're building a way in which facts can be judged, I think, anew. So our one of our biggest goals is to create trillions of geo-based facts. That way you're standing anywhere in the world, even in the middle of the desert, you should be able to look up in augmented reality and learn about your surroundings, even the sand and the crystals beneath your
feet. I freaking love it. I love it. I'll tell you something else. You actually, if I didn't get it before, your story, your personal story about your bookstore brought it home for me. Tell me that story about what happened at your bookstore. Tell me that story real quick.
Well, between 2001 and 2004, after I'd finished my graduate work, I went back and did what every great entrepreneur does, starts a company out of a garage.
Right.
And I started with hundreds of books, selling them online, and that was the beginning of Amazon Marketplace and Barnes & Noble, a lot of resellers of remainders. Right. And I had moved one location. I had a warehouse location, was moving it to a retail location, and I thought I would get a double punch. I could sell online and also sell to retail customers. I would, 6 months would go by, no one would even walk into the store. Until one day, someone finally told me, what, you don't realize what happened at your store? It was a laundromat before, and the owner had been shot and killed in your back office. And at that time, I was sleeping in my back office, actually. Actually, ultimately, got an apartment.
So people lack you lack context. You made that decision, a real estate decision, a business decision, to move your bookstore from a warehouse to a retail store, not knowing that that retail store, that location on planet Earth, that actual geolocation, had history.
Yeah, and later I found a newspaper article. Back then, of course, things weren't so readily online, but I found a newspaper article with the address imprinted in the newspaper article where this happened. Had I been able to link that then, I could have made a better business decision.
Which is basically not to move into that place because people didn't want to come in because of its history.
Karma. There was a phobia or karma based around geopositions.
Absolutely.
Think about that.
Incredible. Yeah. So you're right now, let's call it, you're not stealth, but you haven't launched this platform yet, but you're accumulating an insane amount of data for the platform. You will be launching in the near future. And you're building out your team, you're building out the traction, and you're going to be launching Stops.com.
Absolutely. And
incredible.
You can already download the product if you want, and by October 18th,
absolutely,
it's open
incredible
to the world.
Listen, man, number one, I'm super happy we had the chance to meet. Goes without saying, anything I can do to help. We already discussed some action items. We're going to have a follow-up meeting. If there's an entrepreneur slash investor slash journalist, what is the best way to contact you if they want to get in touch?
Just go to Eitan, E-I-T-A-N, at Stops.com, or just go to our website. You'll reach us.
I have one request from you.
Yes.
I have one ask. I want an email address on your domain.
You know what? We'd be honored.
Hillel@stops.com.
Hillel@stops.com.
That is so, that domain, man. Anyway, dude, listen.
Thank
it was
you.
Fantastic to meet you. This is a kickoff meeting. We're definitely going to continue the conversation. But until we do, and anything pops into your head, you say, you know what? Maybe Hillel can help with that.
This amazing blog. Spread it to all your friends.
Consider it done, my friend.
Yeah.
I love it. I love your story. I love
Thank
that
you.
You're in Israel. I love that everything you've gone through, your journey. I just love it. You know, I grew up Jewish, religious, loving Israel. You didn't grow up. It came to you innately, and I love that. So, again, let's continue this conversation.
Thank you.
Anything I can do to help you, let me know. All right, man?
Bye.
Have a great day. Okay, made it to WeWork Labs. Talk starting soon. Who are you?
I'm Moore. I'm a labs manager here at WeWork Labs.
Do a lot of Americans ask you, is your name really Moore? It's one of those names that, like all these Israeli names that Americans, like Moron or Osnot, people like, but Moore's a little more.
I don't know. Usually at Starbucks, for example, I say Morgan just because they don't know how to deal with Moore.
Are you originally Israeli?
I'm Israeli, yeah, but I grew up abroad.
I was going to say, your English is perfect.
Yeah, I grew up in Mexico and I went to an American school.
Wow,
yeah.
That's random. All right, cool. So we have some start. Who's the audience here?
What we did with WeWork Labs is basically create a new membership for WeWork that is tailor-made for early stage startups.
Awesome.
So what we give them is basically an opportunity to be part of WeWork, but get added value in the shape of workshops, office hours, mentors,
Sweet.
Experts that come here to meet them.
Well, our friend Tom asked me to come here. When Tom asks me to do something, I do it. So I'm here. Let's do this.
Great.
Let's go inside.
Okay.
As long as there's air conditioning, that's the most important thing.
This is the space that is just for our startup members here at WeWork.
Yep.
Each one of the members gets a dedicated desk. It's their own desk. They can leave their stuff.
Awesome.
And they're all part of our systems. We build global programming, and they all basically get to attend workshops, office hours, and different classes that we make for them.
I have one question for you.
Yes.
Do you guys ever sleep? And when I say you guys, I mean WeWork. I mean, You guys are pumping out new products every freaking day. It's like unbelievable. Wait, is Roy Adler WeWork Labs or is he something else?
Yeah, Roy Adler is the head of WeWork Labs. He sits in HQ in New York. And
so let me tell you something. Yeah. This is my claim to fame. I was Saluto user 001. Roy Adler came to Beit Shemesh, kid you not, on a Friday morning to show me Saluto. That's like my claim to fame. I'm a big Roy fanboy. But anyway, now I understand. Now I got the context. Yes. I just closed the loop.
So we have about 20 labs worldwide so far in Sao Paulo and Seoul and in the US and New York and in DC. And now we're here in Israel. Tel Aviv, next building will be Haifa.
Wow.
And then globally, we'll go to Germany and the UK.
So if you want me to do more talks, all those places, no problem.
Yes. So since you're a vetted mentor on our database, all the labs managers worldwide can get in contact with you. We're building everything at a global scale.
I love that. You guys are scaling at a pace I've never seen before in my life. Anyway, let's go to the place where we're talking.
So in Tel Aviv, we have about 50 members that are part of WeWork Labs.
Yeah.
Obviously, all this.
We're on here?
Yes.
Cool. Sweet. Is there air conditioning? That's all I need. Air conditioning.
Air conditioning, yes.
Like blast the air. What's up?
Hey, what's up?
Hey guys, how was the talk, guys? How was it?
Perfect.
That's what I'm talking about. Thank you. So usually when I finish talks, actually always when I finish talks, somebody who's in the audience comes over and says, hello, can I pick your brain? Can we talk about marketing? And I usually take questions. This guy came over, he's like, can I get 10 minutes of your time? And I'm like, oh man, who is this guy? Boy, am I happy that I said yes. I am paying right now an arm and a leg for internet at home because I have to upload this vlog to Joseph every day. Like if I told you how much I'm paying for my internet at home, you actually wouldn't believe me. This guy is changing it all. What's the name of your company?
Unity.
Unity with Y-O-U-N-I-T-Y.
Y-O-U, yeah, it's you and I and technology.
Love it. What the hell is Unity?
Yeah, Unity is delivering a new experience for internet services. Basically, we connect multiple ISPs to give you the best
internet fast, service providers. Yes.
Yes, the best, fast, most reliable, most secure internet at the same cost.
Okay, so here's the thing. I met with a company last week that their pitch is cloud storage. Everyone has their cloud storage that they're not always using. We're creating like a network of users that will share their cloud storage. You're doing that with internet. I have bandwidth at home that I'm not using at, let's call it 4 a.m. or 2 a.m. till 4 a.m. when I'm sleeping. That's bandwidth that's not being used. You're saying to me, let's share that bandwidth with your immediate surroundings.
Exactly. We do sharing economy concept on top of our internet. And the thing that people doesn't understand that the internet doesn't have a cost of creating it. It's not like electricity, gas, and water that you put a lot of money to create it. You just connect someone and you just have internet.
What's your website?
Unity.io. Y-O-U. N-I-T-Y.io.
Can someone today come to the website and sign up?
We're a live and coming soon website. And
no
we're
sign
just,
up?
No sign up yet. We're just building it.
Sign up.
Yep.
Dude, I told you I'll connect you to any CEO in this country because everyone needs fast internet. And the only thing I need from you is to deploy this thing in Beit Shemesh because I need this in my house. You told me to get 80 families together. I consider it done. But in a couple of months, you're going to get licensing for the next kind of generation of your technology. And then you'll be able to deploy in a 3 kilometer radius. And I'll be able to have blazing fast internet. You have that speed test on you? Where's your phone? Show me that speed test. I mean, I, like I said, pay an arm and a leg and I have 100 down, 100 up, and I'm like so proud of it. This guy showed me a speed test, I almost fainted. Let's see if we can you see that? 428.72, and that's upload or that's download?
That's download.
But it's the
same.
Symmetric.
It's symmetric.
Upload, 478. You know, my friend Barry Schwartz, he's a big SEO blogger. He always shows me he has like 900 up and down in the US. And fine, you're seeing this and he's like, oh yeah, it's not a big deal. But for Israel, that's insane. I can upload my vlogs every day instead of an hour. By the way, on regular internet, upload of 3 in Israel, it would take me 2 weeks. But when my internet at home takes me an hour or two, with this I'll upload in
seconds.
Literally, I must have it. All right, bro, listen. Go sign up. You should have a sign up on your website. Go check out the website. But the bottom line is, dude, we got to get this thing on my neighborhood because I'm telling you, everyone in my neighborhood would absolutely love this thing. But beyond that, I'm going to send it over to some CEOs and some people in Israel that would absolutely, because at the end, it's win-win. I mean, they get faster internet, same price. They're not paying more.
Definitely. Not paying more.
Love it, man. Good luck with everything. I'm going to help.
Thank you very much.
Continue the conversation soon.
Okay.
The talk at WeWork went pretty well. Heading now to meet yet another company with an incredible domain, Toon.com. Going to meet the founder at Meat Kitchen. It is blazing hot in Tel Aviv. Made it to Meat Kitchen, where I was privileged to be on a kind of panel of speakers at an APAC dinner a couple of weeks ago. Never been here for lunch. I seriously hope they're even open for lunch. Food there was superb. It looks nice and dark. I'm a little bit concerned right now. Phenomenal. phenomenal restaurant. I've only been here once with the APAC dinner, meat restaurant. How's the food?
Amazing.
It really was, right?
Yeah.
They have this goose liver carpaccio. Honestly, like, just outrageous. Okay, so food was incredible. I'm sitting with this guy who runs, what do you call it, the MD? Yeah. Managing director of Toon.com in Israel. We'll get there, but I have something to say first. Many people don't know this, but my entire career started from blogging. And my entire blogging career started from a guy named Arye Alcha. The guy literally built my first blog. We were partners on techandmarketing.com, which is my blog. He was you before you.
Yes.
He did what you do. Someone else replaced him, and you replaced that guy at Toon.com. So that's my first kind of, I'd say, affiliation slash awareness of Toon.com was through Arye. But beyond your incredible domain, which I can't even imagine how much it cost, side topic, you're ripping it up. I mean, you guys are doing some incredible work. Who are some, just give me off the top of your head, who are some clients of yours?
We have several products, but on the attribution side, it's Amazon, that's Uber, that's big companies at that side, Apple, Twitter, Snapchat.
Couple big names there.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, so
and a lot of small, yeah.
Let's assume right now that my mom is watching. What is Toon.com? My mom is watching, so no buzzwords. What is Toon.com?
We help people advertise online by providing them platforms that they can understand where their marketing dollars went.
Beautiful, yeah. Beautiful. Love it. Which means, if I'm going to dumb it down even more, people are spending money on advertising, and I don't really know, when someone downloads my mobile app, if I have a mobile app, someone downloads it, where did that guy come from? I have no idea. Mm-hmm. That's called app attribution, right? It's seeing the, let's call it the journey, the user journey from, I clicked on a link on Facebook that brought me to, an article on TechCrunch, that I clicked on the article, it sounded interesting, and there it talked about one of the competitors of the, and in that, the list of competitors was this app that I clicked on, that I installed your app.
Yeah.
Me, as an app developer, that's incredibly useful information.
Yeah, that's,
I want to know that.
Something you have to, yeah. Have
beautiful.
To.
So that's one business.
Mm-hmm.
What's the other one?
The other one is HasOffers, which is an affiliate tracking system. It's catering a lot of different verticals in the affiliate industry, from big e-commerce companies to basically every vertical of performance marketing exists today.
So, but it's the same concept, which is tracking and attribution?
Yeah, so it's just tracking, which is not necessarily app. Native apps have different technology. They need a different SDK.
Got it.
The other part of performance marketing.
You're losing my mom with your SDK. My mom doesn't know what an
sorry.
SDK is.
Sorry, that's my last three words.
Mom, sorry for this guy. I apologize.
But basically, like, people advertise today a lot, from small businesses to huge businesses, and they need to understand the dollar that they put, how much money it brought them.
Love
how
it.
Many users, what's the value.
So is it fair to say Toon is a beast of a company that's doing that's doing digital tracking and attribution?
Yes.
Is that
Yeah, that's a good definition.
Your new tagline, yes. Okay, so who are you? Well, first of all, what's your name?
I'm Ophir, Ophir Brill.
By the way, are you related to Galbril? Any relation?
No.
I love Galbril. Okay, so give me your background. Let's start from, like, as far back as you want. Like, what's your background, professionally?
I grew up in a kibbutz up in the north.
Okay.
And army, the usual Israeli.
What did you do in the army? Like 8200 or something?
Nah, I don't know. It's a secret.
Okay. Can tell you, but I don't have to kill you. Okay.
And then I went to business school. Started from a company that did rescue elevators for skyscrapers after 9/11.
Wow.
And then I moved to a company that is doing a startup in the operator. There was the operator boom back then. So startup for recharging phones. And then I was abroad, and I came back and I worked for a toy company.
Wow,
then
man.
I worked for an ad networks, and
done
now
a lot
I'm
of
in tune. Yeah, yeah.
Incredible, I mean, man. So you also have some other passions. Golesh.
Golesh, yeah. That's my girl.
What's it called in English?
Surfing.
Surfing, yeah. What's, what's wrong with me? That stake that affected
brain. I learned subsurfing for the past six months.
So you surf?
So, yeah.
And you're also...
And I'm a father, which is very important.
How many kids do you have?
Two.
Wow, man. Try five. All right, listen. So, but in addition to all that stuff is great. But at the end of the day, I found over the last hour sitting with you that we share an insane amount of things in common in terms of our philosophy and the way we view business.
Yeah.
And the way we view karma and karma's role in business.
Yeah.
And I think you know, at the end of the day, have had an incredible career. You're just getting started, but you have a lot of experience. And so I want to ask you a question. If someone's watching this, and they want to pick your brain, they want to learn from your experience, would you mind them reaching out to you?
I would be happy to.
What is the best way to contact you?
WhatsApp.
You want to give? I don't want to give people your phone number. What's the best email to reach you?
Ophir@tune.com.
O-F-F?
O-F-I-R.
O-F-I-R
at tune.com. But Facebook, Ophir Brill, okay. LinkedIn, Ophir Brill. Yeah.
I have one request from you. You're the second company today that I met with that has the coolest domain ever. The first one was stops.com.
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 That's good.
You know what I asked him? The same thing I'm going to ask you. What do I have to do to get Hillel at Tune.com? I want that. I mean, that's, by the way, do you actually know the story of Tune.com and how you got that domain? Do you know or you don't know?
Actually, I don't know.
I can't even imagine. Like, today, I would imagine you can probably, like, raise an entire, like, growth round of financing by selling that domain. I mean, it's probably worth millions and millions and millions. Yeah. Unbelievable.
No, it's a good name. It's a good domain. Very
how many
catchy.
People work in Tune globally?
Globally, around 300 in around 9 offices all over
wow,
the world.
Incredible. And in Israel, how many people?
In Israel, in the office, we are 25 people.
25 people. And I would imagine it's a super cool place to work.
Yeah.
I got to come to the office next time. But
Tune is an American company and a very, very unique company in terms of the relationship with the industry and this kind of service and kind of...
You know what?
It's a very nice people in the company.
I want to say one more thing before we end this interview because, you know, at the end of the day, like you said, Tune's an American company. And yet, among the massive metropolitans that you guys are located in, where are some of your offices? Just name some names.
New York and Seattle and London and
all the big,
Berlin.
You're in Tel Aviv. Why Tel Aviv?
Seoul.
Why Tel Aviv, man?
Well, that comes back to your to the conversation around Aria. They used to work with Aria. Hezofers is an affiliate tracking system, and Payoneer was helping affiliates transferring money, and they did integration with them, so they knew Aria, and Aria came to them and told them, hey guys, let's open an office in Tel Aviv. By the way, Israel was always a good market for the company.
Okay,
because
why?
There's a lot of media companies here.
Right.
A lot.
Right.
So we have like in Israel, we have a lot of clients all over the years.
Okay.
And it's also in media, Israel is almost like the mecca of media.
There's not only media, by the way, right?
Yeah, many things, but in specifically in media and performance marketing and affiliation, Israel has always been like a center of, you can walk in Rothschild and every 5 minutes you find traffic from a different country.
It's true. I want to tell you something else. You said a lot of cool things in this meeting, but you said one thing that really hit home for me. You said, I could sit on my balcony here in Tel Aviv, and it's probably the most strategic place I can sit in the world.
Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah.
It's true, though. I mean, the amount of business that goes through this street. I mean, Google is like 20 feet from here, and like, you know, Rothschild's 6 minutes from here, and I mean it's just an absolute epicenter of technology and innovation.
I think Israel has always been an epicenter of trade because of its strategic location, and I think today in business, first of all, because we're Jews, so we know how to trade. This is
that's something. Anti-Semitic. I'm just kidding.
Yeah,
it's okay. We're
without
allowed.
The long
I'm
nose,
allowed to make that joke.
Without
they're not
the long nose today. But I think Israel is specifically have a very. I've been working with an American company with Asian clients for many years. And I've seen like this rainbow of communication that Israel is many times have the ability to communicate with all over the world because the scenario, the culture in Israel is very multicultural.
Love it.
So
okay.
We have
let me ask you one more question. Are you having a good time?
With you?
No, in general.
Yes.
With me,
yes.
Of course you're having a good time.
Yeah, I do.
You having a good time here?
I love it. I love Israel. It's a great place to live.
It's the best, right?
I think.
All right, dude, listen, bottom line, anything I can do to help you in any way, you're going to let me know, right?
For sure. Just come have lunch with me. That's the best.
I was just about to say, we could also always come back to Meat Kitchen and have more food here because the food here was bonkers.
Exactly.
It's awesome. Awesome to hang out.
Thank you very much.
Definitely not wait another like 10 years. I don't know what took us this long, but we'll do it again.
I want to tell you, you're an amazing person. I think what you do for the startups in Israel is Zionism. I think we have an amazing variety of companies. I think we have the most talented people here.
I agree.
And yeah, it's fun to
one more
bring
thing.
This word up.
I need that t-shirt.
Okay.
I need some Tune swag.
Can you turn the camera off?
Thanks, guys. Talk soon, man. Thanks.
Bye.
He's ordering his scooter right now. Bird.
I'm going like that press ride. Sababa. And then I come here and I release it. I click unlock.
Yeah.
That's it, man. It's mine. Taking it.
That is so freaking awesome. How is it
and
locked?
I'm gonna leave it something electric. And I'm gonna leave it in the office.
You get your Tune t-shirt, hold on, your Tune t-shirt. That was a pretty awesome meeting. I seriously like that dude. And we are actually going to put on the calendar a monthly meeting. I'm not even kidding. Just to brainstorm, talk tech, talk business. Just really like the guy. And on that note, let the weekend begin. See you next week.